I shoot with a medium format camera, which is a 4x5 Sinar-P. It's the old fashioned, because I'm sort of, it's a 4x5, I'm shooting with film, and I shoot with a, I'm swinging and tilting. By that technically mean I am adjusting the perspective. I'm adjusting to make sure everything is clear as possible. I don't shoot, technically speaking, with what they call a big depth of field, like a f-stop 64, because it's not sharp there. I need to be as sharp and as much clarity as possible. So I'm shooting in the middle, 16, f-stop 16, 22 at the most extreme, and therefore I have to do all adjustments to bring it into focus. Otherwise, it's not sharp enough for me to get this clarity. I tend to shoot at sunset or dark because I'm interested in this idea about what's real or not real. So at this time of day, the reflections, if I see any, are picking up, are mixing with the lights that are on in the building. So I'm taking you in the space. I'm trying to penetrate beyond the surface of the facade of a building. I'm showing you the side of a building, and I'm showing a reflection on the building at the same time. As well as, and those reflections sometimes are about movement and speed, because I'm showing cars reflecting, moving in, and I like that a lot. I like the sometimes, especially things where it's just flickering. The light is just flickering up and moving, and because of all of the vibrations and of the different reflections, because you have a lot of different cars, a lot of different things, and lights reflecting not from one position, but from four or five, and they're all mixing. And so I like that whole sort of, that's that that intensity and detail, which I sort of hear. I can sort of play that too, that's very important, so. And so when I shoot with a 4x5 camera, I shoot with film. And unfortunately, the film that I use is only daylight film. They don't make tungsten nighttime film anymore. So I have to shoot with daylight film. I come back, I have to scan it. Then after it's scanned, I color balance. I try to color balance to normal. I don't do anything tricks with it. I don't do anything in Photoshop, but it's just color balance. Then I try to maintain the sharpness, and then I go off to the printer and it's proofed. And it never looks the way it looks when I thought it was going to look. And so you're just back and forth and back and forth, and finally you say thumbs up or thumbs down, and you print it, like that. But that's also based on the structure and things that I do when I shoot, space and stuff and time and things. Does that give you a little idea?
And how did you come to decide in terms of scale of which you actually wanted to have the works printed? And also, could you talk about the paper that they're printed on?
Well, the size is that it's, I like that that size is 22. That's like my minimum size that I'm comfortable with, because I want you to see all of it. I want you to see all the stories inside and everything. So I want to make big. I mean, if I had the money, in a way, it'd be made twice as big. I like it big because it's sharp, because I want to put you inside the space and have that experience that I have, because it's sort of, it's, to me, it's very energizing and thing to do it and see it. And I love it that sometimes I've had a photograph that I've worked on, I had it for 6 months, and I'm still finding new things in the photograph. That's my goal, to discover and to see, because I can't see it all when I'm going to shoot. When at the time, it's just too much involved. So it's about the structure and putting it there. So I want to have enough room so you can have that experience, and I want it to be, I want to make it intimate. So I need a certain size for me to make a feeling of intimacy that you're a part of the experience.
And